رحمة الله وبركاته. Did everybody enjoy earlier when we had our mashayikh on, as they're coming up on stage? Can I just hear a takbir for them? Ah, subhanallah. How many things does Allah do for us that shows His greatness? Can I have a takbir, please? Alhamdulillah. Very well, very well. Okay, alhamdulillah. Everyone enjoyed the session.
Takbir!
Alhamdulillah. So, guys don't need me anymore. I'll hand over to our wonderful mashayikh, inshallah. Jazakum al-khair. Mufti mate.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Sheikh Mufti.
I don't hear the response from that side. Assalamu alaikum. MashaAllah, now I don't hear it from this side here. Assalamu alaikum. MashaAllah, tabarakallah.
Yeah, Sheikh Mufti. Sheikh
Mufti. Yes, brother. Yes, brother.
It's very, very comfortable.
I think if we stand, MashaAllah, it will be much better. Barakallah. He speaks quite a lot of English, by the way, MashaAllah.
Yes, yes.
Alhamdulillah.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Allahumma ja'al ijtima'ana hadha ijtima'an marhuma.
May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless this gathering.
وَاجْعَلْ تَفَرُّقَنَا مِنْ بَعْدِي تَفَرُّقًا مَعْصُومًا.
And may He allow us to disperse after this, inshallah, in a way that we're forgiven.
وَمَا يُدْرِيكُمْ إِخْوَانِي وَأَخَوَاتِي.
And you don't know, you wouldn't know, my brothers and sisters.
لَعَلَّنَا نَلْتَقِي فِي يَوْمٍ مِنَ الْأَيَّامِ عَلَى أَنْهَارِ الْجَنَّةِ.
Perhaps we may meet one of the days on one of the rivers of Jannah al-Firdaus.
وَيَكُونَ الْعَمَلُ الَّذِي أَرْضَى اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ عَنَّا وَأَدْخَلَنَا الْجَنَّةَ هَذَا الْمَجْلِسِ.
And perhaps the deed that may have granted us entry into Jannah by the mercy of Allah may be this particular gathering.
فَمَنْ هَيَّأَ لَنَا هَذَا الْإِجْتِمَاعَ هُوَ اللَّهُ.
So he who facilitated this for us is Allah.
وَمَنْ اخْتَارَنَا هُوَ اللَّهُ.
And the one who chose us is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
وَمَنْ وَفَّقَنَا هُوَ اللَّهُ.
And the one who has granted us acceptance is Allah.
وَمَنْ أَتَى بِنَا إِلَى هَذَا الْمَكَانِ هُوَ اللَّهُ.
The one who brought us to this place is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
قُولُوا الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ.
So say الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ. الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ. Say الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ. MashaAllah.
الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ كَلِمَةٌ عَظِيمَةٌ.
Alhamdulillah, all praise is due to Allah. That is a very powerful statement.
أخبر النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أنها تملأ الميزان.
The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم informed us that it fills the entire scale.
وأخبر بأنها تملأ ما بين السماء والأرض.
And that it fills from the heavens or between the heavens and the earth completely.
وأنها من الباقيات الصالحات.
And it is one of the good deeds that remain.
بل هي من أحب الكلام إلى الله.
But it is one of the, in fact, it is one of the most loved statements unto Allah.
Everybody say Alhamdulillah.
Everyone say Alhamdulillah. قولوا الحمد لله.
إخواني في الله.
My brothers and sisters in Allah.
إنني أحبكم في الله.
I love you all for the sake of Allah.
أحسن الظن بالله.
Have a good perception of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
ربما هذا المجلس المبارك.
Perhaps this gathering blessed of ours.
يكون سببا لنا في دخول الجنة.
Can be a reason for us to enter جنة الفردوس.
والدليل على ذلك.
And the evidence of that is.
وأقبل بعضهم على بعض يتساءلون.
The people of paradise will meet each other asking each other a question.
قالوا إنا كنا قبل في أهلنا مشفقين.
They say, they will say to each other that before, prior, we were with our families back there, back in the dunya.
فمن الله علينا.
So indeed Allah has favored us, Allah has blessed us and favored us.
فمن الله علينا ووقانا عذاب السموم.
So indeed Allah has bestowed His favor upon us and He has saved us from the painful punishment.
إنا كنا من قبل ندعوه.
We used to in the past call out to Him.
إنه هو البر الرحيم.
Indeed, he is the truthful, the most fulfilling of his word, and at the same time most merciful to the believers.
أهل الجنة يتقابلون في الجنة.
The people of paradise will be meeting each other in paradise. May Allah make us from among them. Say Ameen.
فيسألون بعضهم بعضا.
So they will be asking each other questions.
ما هو سبب دخولنا الجنة؟
What was the reason for us to enter Jannah? How did we get into Jannah?
فيقول قائل منهم.
So one of them will say,
بمجلس جلسناه في الدنيا.
Because of a certain gathering that we sat on earth.
فذكرنا الله.
So we remembered Allah.
فغفر الله لنا.
So Allah forgave our sins.
وأكرمنا بدخول الجنة.
And honored us by granting us entry into جنة الفردوس.
من أجل ذلك أحسن الظن بالله.
This is why I say have a good perception of Allah, who is the most merciful.
ربما يكون هذا المجلس المبارك سببا لنا في دخول الجنة.
Perhaps this particular gathering could be that for us. Allah might grant us جنة الفردوس as a result. سبحان الله.
وهذا يا أخي المجلس قد يكون سبب في نقطة تحول لنا وتجديد علاقتنا مع الله.
A gathering like this, my beloved brothers and sisters, could be the reason for us to change our lives, and it could be a reason for us to change our ways and habits, turn back to Allah and get return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, achieve his happiness.
لأن الله عز وجل قال في القرآن.
Because Allah says in the Quran,
وذكر فإن الذكرى تنفع من.
And remind, for indeed the reminding benefits a certain category. Which category?
تنفع من?
Who does the reminding benefit?
تنفع المؤمنين.
The reminding benefits those who truly believe.
من ينتفع بالذكرى.
Those who are benefited by a reminder.
إذا ذكر بالله عز وجل.
Whenever they are reminded about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
هم أهل الإيمان.
They are the ones who have belief. They are the ones who have faith.
فإذا وجدت نفسك بعد سماع الآيات وبعد سماع حديث النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم تتغير إلى الأفضل وتقبل على الله فهذا دليل على الإيمان.
So if you find yourself, having changed, having benefited from the verses when they are read, if you find your heart softening, and if you find yourself feeling positive when you hear the verses of the Quran, and when you hear what the Prophet, peace be upon him, had to say, then you should know that you are from among those who believe, because it is only the believers who have that feeling within them.
والدليل على ذلك,
and the evidence of it is,
إنما تنذر من اتبع الذكر وخشي الرحمن بالغيب.
Indeed, you warn those who fear Allah in the unseen, those who follow the reminder of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They are the ones who take that as a warning and a reminder. The others don't.
أريد أن أبشر بشرى.
He says, I want to give you some good news, mashallah.
Allah, من كرمه وجوده وفضله, كتب على نفسه الرحمة.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, from his virtue, from his favor, and from his goodness and kindness, he has written upon himself that he shall be merciful.
وَإِذَا جَاءَكَ الَّذِينَ يُؤْمِنُونَ بِآيَاتِنَا فَقُلْ سَلَامٌ عَلَيْكُمْ.
Allah says, when the believers come to you, when those who believe in our verses come to you, then greet them with peace be upon you. Greet them with salamun alaykum. This was an instruction to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
وَإِذَا جَاءَكَ الَّذِينَ يُؤْمِنُونَ بِآيَاتِنَا فَقُلْ سَلَامٌ عَلَيْكُمْ. كتب ربكم على نفسه الرحمة.
When those who believe in our verses come to you, greet them with the greeting, peace be upon you. For indeed Allah has written upon him that he will be merciful.
أنه من عمل منكم سوءا بجهالة ثم تاب.
Allah says, anyone from amongst you who has committed sin in the period of ignorance, in the time when they were ignorant, and then they repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
ثُمَّ تَابَ مِن بَعْدِهِ وَأَصْلَحْ.
If they were to repent to Allah and change their ways, making them good.
فَأَنَّهُ غَفُورٌ رَّحِيمٌ.
So indeed they will find him to be the most merciful, the most forgiving.
يا إخواني ويا أخواتي, نحن لن ندخل الجنة إلا إذا رحمنا الله.
My brothers and sisters, none of us will enter Jannah unless and except if Allah has mercy upon us.
والرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم قال للصحابة رضوان الله عليهم ولأمته من بعدهم.
And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said to the Sahaba, to his companions and to the Ummah who were to follow later,
لن تدخلوا الجنة بأعمالكم.
You will not enter paradise due to your deeds.
قالوا ولا أنت يا رسول الله.
They said, what about you, O Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم.
قال ولا أنا إلا أن يتداركنا الله برحمته.
He says, not even me unless Allah has had mercy on myself and all of us.
يسأل سائل ويقول.
A questioner questions and asks.
إن كان نحن لن ندخل الجنة إلا برحمة الله.
If we are not going to enter paradise except by the mercy of Allah,
فلماذا نعمل?
So why do we have to do deeds? Moments ago he said that if you do deeds, or our deeds will not be able to get us into paradise except through the mercy of Allah. So the question is, so why then should we do deeds?
الإنسان لن يحصل على رحمة الله إلا إذا عمل أعمال صالحة توجب له محبة الله ورحمة الله.
A person will never be able to achieve the mercy of Allah unless they do the deeds that will call on the mercy of Allah. So when you do your deeds, you actually then call on the mercy of Allah for Allah to have mercy on you as a result of you doing the deeds for the sake of Allah.
لذلك الله عز وجل في القرآن الكريم والنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في سنته ذكروا لنا أعمال كثيرة إذا فعلناها وجبت لنا رحمة الله.
And this is why in the Quran Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned, and in the hadith the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم has spoken about in so many places deeds that if you were to do them you would be able to achieve the mercy of Allah, because it is through that mercy that you will then get paradise.
لذلك نحن سنذكر بعض الآيات وبعض الأحاديث التي فيها أعمال إذا عملنا هذه الأعمال يرحمنا الله سبحانه وتعالى. So, لأننا نريد أن نكون عمليين.
So we want to make mention of those verses of the Quran and some of the ahadith or the statements of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم wherein there are deeds that would achieve the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because we want to be practical.
الله سبحانه وتعالى يقول في سورة الأعراف.
Allah says in سورة الأعراف.
ورحمتي وسعت كل شيء.
My mercy has definitely included absolutely everything.
يقول أحد الصالحين في هذه الآية. يا من رحمتك وسعت كل شيء عبدك شيء من الأشياء فاغفر له ورحمه.
One of the predecessors has said that, O you whose mercy has encompassed absolutely everything, I want you to know that this worshipper is one of the things included in the term everything.
الله جل وعلا قال فسأكتبها, أي هذه الرحمة.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that I will write this mercy, I will prescribe it for those. The mercy, Allah says he will prescribe it for those whom.
فَسَأَكْتُبُهَا لِلَّذِينَ يَتَّقُونَ.
I will write the mercy for those who are conscious of me, those who engage in piety, those who are pious, who try hard to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
فَسَأَكْتُبُهَا لِلَّذِينَ يَتَّقُونَ وَالتَّقْوَى أَن تَجْعَلَ بَيْنَكَ وَبَيْنَ عَذَابِ اللَّهِ وِقَايَةً.
Allah says he will prescribe it for those whom have the taqwa in them, and the term taqwa, the meaning of it includes to create a barrier between yourself and the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by doing good deeds and abstaining from bad deeds.
بِفِعْلِ طَاعَةِ اللَّهِ.
By doing that which is in obedience with Allah.
وترك ما حرم الله
and quitting that which Allah has prohibited
والثبات حتى الممات
and to remain steadfast on that up to death as far as possible
فسأكتبها للذين يتقون
So Allah says, I have written this beautiful mercy of mine for those who have taqwa.
يقول علي بن أبي طالب
علي بن أبي طالب رضي الله عنه says
يعرف التقوى فيقول
He is giving the translation of taqwa and he says it means
هي الخوف من الجليل
It is the consciousness or the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala
والرضا بالقليل
and to be happy and content with the small provision in this world
والعمل بالتنزيل
and to practice upon revelation
ومعنى التنزيل أي كتاب الله
and revelation is obviously referring to the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala
وسنة نبينا محمد
and the sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam
والاستعداد ليوم الرحيل
and to prepare for the day that you are going to leave you are going to go leave from this earth and enter into the hereafter
هذه هي التقوى
this is the meaning of taqwa this is what taqwa means
لن يدخل أحدكم الجنة إلا إذا تمسك بهذه التقوى
we cannot enter into paradise unless and until we try our best to hold as fast as possible onto this taqwa
تلك الجنة
That Jannah that Allah has prepared
هذه الجنة العظيمة
The paradise that is so great
الذي فيها من النعيم الشيء العظيم
That has in it from the gifts of Allah so many and so great
الحور
The حور
الأنهار
The rivers
القصور
The castles
لذة النظر إلى وجه الله
The sweetness at looking
الفرح
to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the happiness
كلها
All of these things
لن يدخلها إلا المتقين
Only those with taqwa shall enter this Jannah
والدليل
And the evidence of it
تلك الجنة التي نورث من عبادنا من كان تقيا
This Jannah that we have prepared we will grant it to our worshippers those who had taqwa
اللهم اجعلنا من أهل التقوى.
May Allah make us from among those who have taqwa. Say Ameen.
فسأكتبها للذين يتقون.
Going back to that verse, Allah says, We have written this mercy for those who have this taqwa.
ويؤتون الزكاة.
And they give alms to the poor, the charities. They are charitable with what Allah has given them.
هذا العمل الثاني الذي يوجب لك رحمة الله. الزكاة والصدقة بشكل عام.
This is the second deed that would actually be able to achieve the mercy of Allah. A person will achieve the mercy of Allah by doing this deed as well. It is being charitable. Zakah actually refers to two things. One is to cleanse oneself and two is to be charitable and to be able to give others from what Allah gave you. If you're ready to do that, you will achieve the mercy of Allah. You share what Allah has given you.
الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم قال
The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم has said
الصدقة تطفئ غضب الرب كما يطفئ الماء النار.
Charities extinguish the anger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the same way that water extinguishes fire.
وقال صلى الله عليه وسلم اتقوا النار ولو بشق تمرة ليس بتمرة كاملة وإنما ولو بنصف تمرة.
The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم has said be conscious or be fearful of the hellfire Even if it meant by a portion of a date, not the whole date, just half of it, a portion of it.
فالنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ممن نفعه وساهم في خدمة الدين والإسلام والمسلمين أبو بكر رضي الله عنه وأرضاه.
The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, one of those who helped him and stood by him and assisted him in fulfilling this beautiful mission, was a man known as Abu Bakr as-Siddiq رضي الله عنه.
أبو بكر رضي الله عنه وأرضاه في بداية الإسلام كان هناك بعض فقراء الصحابة الذين أسلموا.
At the beginning of Islam, there were a few poor people who had accepted Islam.
كانوا رقيق عبيد.
They were enslaved at the time. They were slaves.
فحينما أسلموا وآمنوا قام بعض ساداتهم بتعذيبهم.
So when they had accepted Islam, some of their masters happened to punish them as a result of them accepting Islam.
فكان أبو بكر رضي الله عنه وأرضاه يأتي بماله ويشتري هذا الصحابي من سيده ويعتقه لوجه الله.
So Abu Bakr as-Siddiq رضي الله عنه used to come with some of his own wealth and he used to purchase the freedom of these people and free them for the sake of Allah so that they would no longer be under the ownership of those people. They would be free to worship Allah.
فجاء أبوه.
So one of the men, his father came.
وعاتبه.
In fact, the father of Abu Bakr came and scolded him.
وقال له يا أبا بكر.
And told him, Oh Abu Bakr.
لماذا تشتري هؤلاء وتعتق هؤلاء الضعفاء؟ اعتق أقوياء حتى ينفعونك في المستقبل.
Why are you freeing these weak people, those who are weak? Why don't you free those who are strong so that they can benefit you in the future?
فقال له أبو بكر رضي الله عنه أرضاه.
So Abu Bakr as-Siddiq رضي الله عنه said to him, to his own father.
قال يا أبتي إني أبتغي وجه الله.
He says, والله I'm only doing this for the sake of Allah.
فأنزل الله سبحانه وتعالى قوله.
So Allah has revealed the verse.
وسيجنبها الأتقى.
And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will keep away from the fire of hell those who were conscious, or the one who was conscious.
الذي يؤتي ماله يتزكى.
The one who gave his wealth or gives his wealth in charity.
وما لأحد عنده من نعمة تجزى.
And none could actually recompense such a person. They would not be doing it for any other purpose besides the pleasure of Allah.
إلا ابتغاء وجه ربه الأعلى.
They would only be doing it in order to achieve the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
إلا ابتغاء وجه ربه الأعلى ولسوف يرضى.
And very soon, inshallah, he will be happy. Meaning the one who has spent wealth will be saved from the fire and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will grant them goodness and at the same time they will be happy at the end.
أبشركم بشرى.
Says, I give you a piece of good news.
يا من تتصدقون لوجه الله.
O you who are spending for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
إن الله سبحانه وتعالى يربي هذه الصدقة.
Allah will grant your charities growth.
كما يربي أحدكم فلوة.
Just like one of you would actually achieve growth of their plant.
حتى تصبح يوم القيامة مثل الجبال.
Until it will become like a whole mountain on the day of judgment.
لأن الله.
Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
أكرم الأكرمين.
Is the most honorable of the honored.
والدليل على ذلك.
And the evidence of it.
من جاء بالحسنة.
He or she who comes with a good deed on the day of judgment.
من جاء بالحسنة فله عشر أمثالها.
Whoever comes with a good deed on the day of judgment, it will be multiplied for them tenfold.
من أجل ذلك أنتم تتعاملون مع الشكور.
And this is why we say that you are working with the one who recompenses and shows that gratitude in the biggest way.
من هو الشكور؟
Who is he who is most grateful?
الذي
He is the one
يجازي بالعمل القليل الأجر الكثير.
Who gives a recompense of a small deed in a very, very big way. That is Allah. Allah. One of his names is Ash-Shakur, because when you do something small, he actually gives you back in return much more than your little deed that you had done.
والدليل على ذلك
and the evidence of it is
في سورة فاطر
in سورة فاطر
إن ربنا لغفور شكور.
Indeed, our Lord is most forgiving, most grateful, meaning he shows gratitude by multiplying that which you've done in a bigger way compared to what you've done.
قال أحد العلماء معلقا على هذه الآية.
One of the scholars have said regarding this verse.
إن ربنا لغفور شكور.
The same verse that he has made mention of.
غفر كثيرا من الزلل.
That Allah has forgiven so many sins.
وشكر قليلا من العمل.
And he has thanked very small deeds in a very very big way.
الله أكبر ما أكرمك يا الله.
Oh Allah, how great you are.
قال الله.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
فسأكتبها للذين يتقون.
That Allah has written this mercy for those who have taqwa.
ويؤتون الزكاة.
And those who are charitable, they give.
نحن في هذه الدنيا بيننا وبين الشمس 150 مليون كيلو متر.
Us in this world, between us and the sun, there is 150 million kilometers.
أنتم في لندن لا تعرفون حرارة الشمس.
Here in London, you don't know what heat actually means.
نحن في السعودية نعرفها جيدا.
We in the Middle East know exactly what it is.
لأن درجة الحرارة عندنا تصل إلى 60 درجة حرارة.
Because where we come from, the temperature rises almost to 60 degrees.
وبيننا وبينها في الدنيا 150 مليون كيلو.
Yet there is 150 million kilometers between us and the sun.
لكن يوم القيامة.
But on the day of judgment.
هذه الشمس.
The sun.
ستدنو من رؤوس الخلائق مقدار ميل.
Will become so close to the heads of the human beings.
فيغرق الناس.
So people will be drowning
في عرقهم على قدر أعمالهم.
In their own sweat according to the deeds that they've done.
منهم من يكون إلى كعبيه.
Some of them their sweat will be up to the ankles.
ومنهم من يكون إلى ركبتيه.
Some of them up to their knees.
ومنهم إلى حقويه.
Some of them up to their waist.
ومنهم إلى منكبيه.
Some up to the shoulders.
ومنهم من يلجم العرق الجم.
And some they will be drowning in their own sweat.
على قدر أعمالهم في الدنيا.
According to the deeds they've done, the bad deeds that they've done on earth.
لكن أبشركم بشارة.
But there is a piece of good news.
المؤمن يأتي تحت ظل صدقته يوم القيامة.
A believer will be shaded by the shade of the charity that he has given during his time on earth. So be charitable, my brothers and sisters.
الله أكبر.
وهناك سبع يظلهم الله تحت ظله يوم لا ظل إلا ظله.
And there is a narration where the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم speaks of seven categories of people whom Allah will grant a special shade, the shade of His arsh, on the day that there will be no other shade besides that.
The first one.
The first one, الأولى.
يا سلام. شاب نشأ في طاعة الله.
A young person who had grown up and use that youth in the obedience of Allah.
إمام عادل.
A just ruler.
رجل تعلق قلبه بالمساجد.
A man or a man whose heart is connected to the masjid.
رجلان تحابا في الله اجتمع عليه وتفرق عليه.
Two people who love each other for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they gather in His love and they depart in the same.
ورجل.
And a person.
دعته امرأة ذات منصب وجمال.
Who is called to commit adultery by the opposite sex.
فقال لها إني أخاف الله.
And he says that indeed I fear Allah. Or she says.
ورجل.
And a person.
ذكر الله خاليا ففاضت عيناه من الدم.
Who remembers Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone when they're alone and their eyes are filled with tears. Remember, this is for male and female together. Not every time the hadith says rajul, does it mean man. Some of you might be noticing the translation. I'm not making a mistake.
That's right. Good, sir.
Alhamdulillah.
فَسَأَكْتُبُهَا لِلَّذِينَ يَتَّقُونَ.
What a beautiful verse, subhanAllah. Allah says,
wait,
that
my brother.
I've written the mercy for those who have taqwa.
Wait, my brother. The seventh one.
Okay, the seventh one, yes. أهم حاجة.
رجل أنفق بيمينه ولم تعلم شماله ماذا أنفق.
A person who has given a charity with his or her right hand in such a way that even the left hand doesn't know what the right hand did. What that means is that when we spend, we actually spend without advertising that we've given. We want nothing in return besides the pleasure of Allah. We don't want perks, we don't want acknowledgements, nothing. Allah knows, we know, and that's it.
هو البعض يظن هكذا.
Yeah, some people think that what it means is you must put your left hand behind your back whenever you are giving a charity.
لا ولكن
That's not what it means.
أن يكون نيته خالصة لوجه الله ولا يعلم به أحد من البشر.
It means that the intention needs to be for the sake of Allah alone and no one knows besides the minimum, like for example the one you've given may know. Subhanallah.
فنسأل الله أن يظلنا تحت ظل عرشه يوم لا ظل إلا.
So we ask Allah to grant us the shade of His arsh on the day that there will be no shade besides that particular shade.
آمين. نرجع مرة أخرى نذكر إخواننا بالأعمال التي تجلب لنا رحمة.
We return to the topic of speaking of the deeds that will result in drawing the mercy of Allah
فسأكتبها للذين يتقون.
So we will write the mercy upon those who have taqwa.
ويؤتون الزكاة.
And those who fulfill their charities.
والذين هم بآياتنا يؤمنون.
And those who believe with conviction in our verses and signs.
يؤمنون بآيات الله ويعملون بمقتضى هذه الآيات.
They believe in revelation in the verses that Allah has revealed and they work upon these beautiful verses and instructions of Allah سبحانه وتعالى.
فإن الله لم ينزل إلينا هذه الآيات العظيمة إلا من أجل أن نتفكر فيها ونتأمل فيها ونعمل بها.
So Allah has not revealed these verses except for us to look into them and learn them and think about them and take lesson from them.
لا نريد أن نقرأها مثل ما نقرأ المجلات والجرائد.
We don't want to read the Quran just like we read a magazine or the newspapers.
نريد أن نقرأها ونعمل بها.
We want to read it and we want to act upon it.
والدليل على ذلك.
The evidence of that.
كتاب أنزلناه مبارك.
A book that we have revealed to you that is very, very blessed.
كتاب أنزلناه إليك مبارك ليدبروا آياته.
A book that we have revealed to you that is blessed. Talking about the Quran, the reason of that revelation is for its verses to be pondered over.
ليدبروا آياته وليتذكر أولو الألباب.
In order that the verses be pondered over and it can be a reminder for those with sound intellect. That is the purpose of revelation of this Quran.
إن هذا القرآن العظيم.
This great Quran.
كلام من.
Is the word of whom?
الله.
كلام من.
الله الله.
كلام الله.
It's the word of Allah.
بواسطة أعظم الملائكة من.
It was sent down through the greatest of angels and who was he?
جبريل.
جبريل عليه السلام.
ثم نزل على قلب أفضل البشر من.
Then it came down into the heart of the best of humankind. Whom?
محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم.
صلى الله عليه وسلم.
ثم نزل في أعظم الشهور شهر رمضان.
Then it was sent in the most blessed of months. That's the month of Ramadan.
ثم نزل في أعظم الليالي ليلة القدر.
Then in the most blessed of the nights of Ramadan, and that is ليلة القدر.
والله والله لو نزل القرآن في قلبي وفي قلوبكم لأصبحنا أفضل البشر.
Wallahi, if this Quran has to enter into our hearts, my heart, your hearts, we will become the best of the people.
وَلَقَدْ أَنزَلْنَا إِلَيْكُمْ آيَاتٍ مُبَيِّنَاتٍ.
Allah says, and indeed we have revealed to you clear-cut verses.
وَمَثَلًا مِنَ الَّذِينَ خَلَوْا مِن قَبْلِكُمْ.
And similitudes of those who have passed before you.
وَمَوْعِظَةً لِلْمُتَّقِينَ.
And a reminder for those who have taqwa, who are conscious of Allah.
اللهم اجعلنا ممن يقرأ هذا الكلام ويتأمل معانيه.
May Allah make us from those who read the Quran and who ponder over its meaning. Amin. Say Amin.
من عظمة القرآن عند الله سبحانه وتعالى
from the greatness of the Quran.
أن الله سبحانه وتعالى جعل الاستماع والإنصات للقرآن سببا لرحمة الله.
الله أكبر. From the greatness of this beautiful Quran that Allah has revealed is that Allah has kept the mercy of Allah specially for those who listen attentively and keep quiet when the Quran is being recited. Just by listening to the Quran.
والدليل على ذلك.
And the evidence of it is.
وإذا قرئ القرآن.
Whenever the Quran is read.
وإذا قرئ القرآن فاستمعوا له وأنصتوا.
Whenever the Quran is read, then listen very attentively and keep quiet.
فَاسْتَمِعُوا لَهُ وَأَنصِتُوا لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ.
Then listen very attentively and keep quiet in order that you achieve the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
وَمِنَ الْأَعْمَالِ الَّتِي تُوجِبْ لَنَا رَحْمَةَ اللَّهِ.
And one of the deeds that would actually call on the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala,
ta'atullah wa ta'atul rasul sallallahu alayhi,
to follow Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's instructions and that of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
والدليل,
and the evidence of it,
وَأَطِيعُ اللَّهَ وَالرَّسُولَ,
follow Allah and follow His Messenger.
وَأَطِيعُ اللَّهَ وَالرَّسُولَ,
follow Allah, follow His Messenger.
وأطيع الله والرسول لعلكم ترحمون.
The verse says, follow Allah, follow His Messenger, in order that you may achieve the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
فَسَأَكْتُبُهَا لِلَّذِينَ يَتَّقُونَ.
Again, back to the verse. Allah says He will write the mercy for those who have taqwa, who are conscious of Him.
وَيُؤْتُونَ الزَّكَاةَ,
and those who are charitable.
وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ بِآيَاتِنَا يُؤْمِنُونَ,
and those who believe in our verses and signs.
الَّذِينَ يَتَّبِعُونَ الرَّسُولَ النَّبِيَّ الْأُمِّيَّ الَّذِي يَجِدُونَهُ مَكْتُوبًا عِندَهُمْ فِي التَّوْرَاةِ وَالْإِنْجِيلِ.
Those who follow the Prophet, those who follow the Prophet who was sent to them, the Prophet who was unlettered, and those who follow him who was mentioned in the Torah and the Injil before, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, they are the ones who will achieve the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
يَأْمُرُهُمْ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَيَنْهَاهُمْ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ.
What does he instruct? The messenger instructs them to do good and prohibits them from doing bad.
وَيُحِلُّ لَهُمُ الطَّيِّبَاتِ,
and he makes permissible that which is good and pure.
وَيُحَرِّمُ عَلَيْهِمُ الْخَبَائِثِ,
and he prohibits everything that is impure and unclean.
وَيَضَعُ عَنْهُمْ إِسْرَهُمْ وَالْأَغْلَالَ الَّتِي كَانَتْ عَلَيْهِمْ,
and he breaks them free from the shackles that were upon them.
فَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا بِهِ وَعَزَّرُوهُ وَنَصَرُوهُ وَاتَّبَعُوا النُّورِ.
Those who have followed him, those who have believed in him, and those who have followed the light.
وَاتَّبَعُوا النُّورَ الَّذِي أُنزِلَ مَعَهُ أُولَئِكَ هُمُ الْمُفْلِحُونَ.
And those who have followed the light, meaning the Quran that was revealed to him, they are indeed the ones who will definitely be successful.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ذكر لنا في القرآن,
Allah has mentioned in the Quran,
أقوام فعلوا جرائم عظام,
about nations that have done great crimes.
ورغم ما فعلوا إلا أن الله فتح لهم باب الأمل والرحمة ولم يقنطهم من رحمته.
And even those who have done so much in terms of wrong, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala still showed them the doors of forgiveness and the doors of His mercy.
أصحاب الأخدود في نجران في منطقة عندنا في جنوب المملكة,
those Ashab al-Ukhdud who happened to be in the southern part of Saudi Arabia many, many years back,
حفروا خندقا عظيما.
They dug a huge trench.
وأشعلوا فيه نارا.
And they lit a fire.
وجعلوا هذه النار وهذا الخندق لكل من آمن بالله.
And they said, anyone who believes in Allah, we will cast them into this.
إما أن يؤمن بال... إما أن يكفر بالله وإما أن يلقى في هذه النار.
Either they disbelieve in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or they will be thrown into this fire that we've made.
وبدأوا يحضرون الرجال والنساء.
And they started bringing the men and the women forth.
من يكفر يعود ومن يستمر على إيمانه يلقى في النار.
Whoever said they were disbelievers, they were told you can go back, it's fine. Whoever said they believed in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, from the men and the women, they were thrown into the fire.
وأحرقوا عباد الله المؤمنين.
And they burnt a lot of people who believed.
رغم ذلك لم يقنطهم الله من رحمته.
But still Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not make them lose hope in His mercy.
وهذا الكلام في القرآن.
And this is in the Quran. Allah makes mention of it in the Quran.
في سورة البروج.
In Surah Al-Buruj.
إن الذين فتنوا المؤمنين والمؤمنات.
Those who have tried, tested the believing males and females, meaning those criminals who had burnt those males and females from among the believers.
إن الذين فتنوا المؤمنين والمؤمنات ثم لم يتوبوا.
Those who had perpetrated those crimes against the believing males and females, and then they did not repent from those sins.
فلهم عذاب جهنم ولهم عذاب الحريق.
They will have the punishment of hellfire, and they will be the ones who will burn.
كفار قريش.
The kuffar of Quraysh, the people of Quraysh.
ماذا فعلوا بالنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم?
What did they do to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم?
وماذا فعلوا بالصحابة?
What did they do to the companions of Rasulullah?
شتموهم.
They swore them.
وكذبوه.
They belied them.
وعذبوا الصحابة رضوان الله عليهم.
They punished the companions who believed.
وحاولوا قتل النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And they tried to kill the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
وقاتلوا النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم والصحابة.
And they fought the Prophet and his companions.
وقتلوا 70 من صحابة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في غزوة واحدة.
And they executed or killed 70 of the companions in one of the battles.
وشجوا وجه النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وكسروا ربعيته.
And they caused injury to the face of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and broke his tooth.
وعبدوا الأصنام.
And they worshipped whatever they did.
وشربوا الخمور.
They drank alcohol intoxicants.
وفعلوا جرائم لا تعد ولا تحصى.
They perpetrated crimes and committed sins that we lost count of.
بماذا أمر النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم بماذا أمر الله النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أن يقول لهم?
What did Allah tell the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم to tell those type of people?
قل للذين كفروا إن ينتهوا يغفر لهم ما قد سلف.
Say to those who have disbelieved that if they stop and if they turn, Allah will forgive every single thing that they've done in the past.
قل للذين كفروا إن ينتهوا يغفر لهم ما قد سلف وإن يعودوا فقد مضت سنة الأولين.
And if they were to return to their old ways and habits, then indeed the lessons of the past are all there.
المنافقون في المدينة.
The hypocrites of Medina Munawwara.
كانوا يبطنون الكفر ويظهرون الإسلام.
They used to pretend to be Muslims, but they were not.
وهم من أخطر الناس على الإسلام والمسلمين.
And they were the most dangerous against the Muslims and against Islam.
كانوا يقفون في صف المشركين واليهود ضد الإسلام والمسلمين.
They used to stand with the enemies against Islam.
ومع ذلك والله سبحانه وتعالى أخبر بأن من يموت على النفاق سيكون في الدرك الأسفل من النار.
And Allah says, whoever dies upon hypocrisy, where they were showing something that wasn't in terms of hiding the disbelief and pretending to be believers, they will be in the lowest level of hellfire.
ومع ذلك
And still Allah says,
لم يقنطهم الله من رحمته.
He did not make them lose hope in His mercy.
والدليل على ذلك في سورة النساء.
And the evidence of it is in سورة النساء.
إن المنافقين في الدرك الأسفل من النار.
Indeed, the hypocrites, the munafiqeen, will be in the lowest possible levels of hellfire.
ولن تجد لهم نصيرا.
You will never find anyone to help them.
ثم استثنى الله عز وجل من تاب.
But Allah makes an exception from amongst them of who repents to Him.
إلا الذين تابوا وأصلحوا واعتصموا بالله.
Except, meaning from among those hypocrites who would be punished, the exception is made of those who repent to Allah. They change their bad ways and they dedicate their lives to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
إِلَّا الَّذِينَ تَابُوا وَأَصْلَحُوا وَاعْتَصَمُوا بِاللَّهِ وَأَخْلَصُوا دِينَهُمْ لِلَّهِ.
Those who hold fast unto what Allah has revealed and those who turn back to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants.
فَأُولَٰئِكَ مَعَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ.
Those will now be considered as, or they will be with the true believers.
وَسَوْفَ يُؤْتِ اللَّهُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ أَجْرًا عَظِيمًا.
And indeed Allah will favor the true believers with a great reward.
الآن سمعتم في القرآن رحمة الله بمن كفروا من أصحاب الأخدود وعذبوا المؤمنين.
So these examples now you have just heard the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for those who had disbelieved and those who had harmed the mu'mins and the muslimin, those who had perpetrated crimes, that was Allah's offer to them and that was the mercy of Allah for them.
وسمعتم أيضا رحمة الله بمن آمن وتاب من كفار قريش.
And you've also heard about the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon those from the kuffar of Quraysh who have accepted the deen and repented to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
هذا وأيضا سمعتم رحمة الله بالمنافقين.
And you've also heard about the mercy of Allah for those who were hypocrites if they were to change their ways and habits.
هذه رحمة الله بمن حاربوه.
This is the mercy of Allah for those who have fought against Him.
هذه رحمة الله بمن حاربوا أنبياءه وأولياءه.
This is the mercy of Allah for those who have fought the messengers of Allah and His friends.
هذه رحمة الله بمن قتل عباد الله المؤمنين وحرقهم.
This is the mercy of Allah for those who have killed the believers and who have burnt some of them as per the examples in the Quran.
فكيف هي رحمة الله بعباده المؤمنين إذا عادوا.
So what do you think is going to be the mercy of Allah to you and I, the worshippers of Allah, if we were to return to Allah?
اتصل بي في يوم من الأيام شاب من شباب المسلمين.
He says, one day I received a phone call from one of the youth from amongst the Muslims.
فقال لي.
And he told me.
أنا لا أظن أن الله سيغفر لي.
I don't think Allah will forgive me.
فسألته بعض الأسئلة.
I asked him a few questions.
هل كفرت بالله؟
Have you disbelieved in Allah?
قال لا.
He says no.
قلت له هل قتلت نفس حرمها الله؟
Have you killed someone? Have you murdered someone?
قال لا.
He says no.
هل فعلت الزنا والعياذ بالله؟ قال لا.
Have you committed adultery, fornication? He says no.
قلت له لو أشركت بالله وقتلت النفس التي حرم الله وفعلت هذا الزنا والعياذ بالله ثم عدت إلى الله لقبلك الله وغفر الله لك.
He says, I told him, if you were to engage in shirk and if you were to perpetrate the crimes, if you were to disbelieve in Allah, if you were to commit that adultery or fornication and you were to turn in repentance to Allah after that, Allah would forgive all of that.
وليس يغفرها لك وحسب.
And he would not just forgive you and that's it.
وإنما يبدل السيئات إلى حسنات.
But if you were to change your ways truly, he would convert your bad deeds into good deeds.
وهذا في القرآن.
And this is in the Quran.
في سورة الفرقان.
In سورة الفرقان.
والذين لا يدعون مع الله إلها آخر.
Allah makes mention of an exception after he speaks of the punishment. He says the exception is for those who do not call out to deities besides Allah.
وَلَا يَقْتُلُونَ النَّفْسَ الَّتِي حَرَّمَ اللَّهُ إِلَّا بِالْحَقِّ.
And they do not commit murder.
وَلَا يَزْنُونَ.
And they do not commit adultery.
وَمَن يَفْعَلْ ذَلِكَ يَلْقَ أَثَامًا.
Whoever does any of these things, they have committed a grave sin.
يُضَاعَفْ لَهُ الْعَذَابُ.
The punishment will be very severe for that person.
يُضَاعَفْ لَهُ الْعَذَابُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ وَيَخْلُدْ فِيهِ مُهَانًا.
The punishment will be very severe for that person, and they will dwell for a very long time in a very disgraceful place.
ثُمَّ اسْتَثْنَى سُبْحَانَهُ التَّائِبِينَ.
Then Allah made an exception of those who have repented to Allah. That's the exception I was speaking about earlier, where Allah says, after he makes mention of the punishment of all these, he says, except those who have repented. The acceptance is of those who have repented to Allah.
تاب وآمن وعمل عملا صالحا.
Those who have done three things, they have repented to Allah and believed truly in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and changed their lives in a way that they have done good deeds thereafter.
فأولئك.
So those are the ones whom.
فأولئك يبدل الله سيئاتهم حسنات.
Those are the ones whom Allah will convert their bad deeds into good deeds after that.
وكان الله غفورا رحيما.
And indeed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is most forgiving, most merciful.
من الأعمال العظيمة التي توجب للإنسان رحمة الله ومحبة الله التوبة والعودة إلى الله.
One of the biggest ways of achieving the mercy of Allah, the deeds that would actually draw the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is to seek the forgiveness of Allah and to return to Allah.
وهناك دليل من كتاب الله.
And there is evidence in the Quran.
في سورة البقرة.
In سورة البقرة.
إن الله يحب التوابين.
Allah loves those who constantly repent to Him.
إن الله يحب التوابين ويحب المتطهرين.
Allah loves those who constantly repent to Him and those who are pure and clean.
أنا أريد أن أسأل الشيخ منصور سؤال.
Says I want to ask Sheikh Mansour a question.
ما هي أرجى آية في القرآن؟
What is the most the verse of the Quran that has in it the most hope?
أرجى آية في القرآن.
The verse with the most hope in the Quran.
كما قال ابن مسعود.
As per what Ibn Mas'ud رضي الله عنه said.
هي آية في سورة الزمر.
It is a verse in سورة الزمر.
وقال الله.
And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said.
قل يا عبادي الذين أسرفوا على أنفسهم.
Tell my worshippers, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, O my worshippers, those who have transgressed against themselves, those who have sinned, no matter what sin they've committed.
لا تقنطوا من رحمة الله.
Never ever lose hope in the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
إن الله الله يغفر الذنوب جميعا.
Indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive every single sin that you've committed.
إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ.
For indeed he is most forgiving, most merciful.
هذا سؤالي للشيخ منصور وأجاب إجابة رائعة.
He says, that was my question to Sheikh Mansour, and he answered an awesome answer.
أنا الآن أريد أن أسألكم جميعا.
He says, I want to ask all of you a question.
والمشاهدين.
All those who are present and all those who are seeing.
لو أنا طلبت منكم أمر وأنتم تستطيعون أن تعطوني هذا الأمر هل ستمتنعون؟
He says, if I had to ask you for something and you were able to do that for me, would you say no if it was easy for you to do? Would you?
أكيد يمنعون.
No. He says, well, I think they would say no.
أنا.
إيش يقولون؟
He says, I would say no.
I ask him.
Yes, he's saying that I asked you guys, not him. Yeah. MashaAllah.
تمام. ماذا قالوا؟
قالوا ما نرفض.
لماذا؟
He says, why would you not deny me?
ماذا قدمت لكم؟
What have I done for you?
أنا إنسان مثلي مثلكم.
I'm just like you. I've done nothing for you. What have I done for you? Sorry? Well, يقولون ذكرتمونا تذكير.
أنا لم أقدم لكم شيء. أنا أتيت هنا أقدم لنفسي لأني أريد النجاة من عند الله.
He says, I haven't done anything for you. If I've come and spoken, I've spoken in order to remind myself so that I can actually get closer to Allah.
ولكنكم جاوبتم واستجبتم لطلبي لأنكم كرماء.
But you have actually said that you would do what I've asked you to do because you are people of honor. Is that right? خلاص.
لو كان الطلب من الله لو كان الذي يريد منهم أمر الله وليس أنا ولله المثل الأعلى.
What if the one who was asking you for something that you can do is actually Allah, not just an ordinary human being, but Allah.
لو أنت تعلم بأن الله يريد منك أمر وأنت تستطيع أن تحقق هذا الأمر ماذا سيكون جوابك؟
If you know that Allah is asking you to do something and you can do it, what will your answer be?
Yes. الله سبحانه وتعالى يريد مني ومنكم جميعا أمر.
Allah wants from you and I something.
اسمعوا ماذا يريد الله عز وجل.
Listen to it.
والله يريد.
Allah wants the following.
والله يريد أن يتوب عليكم.
Allah wants to forgive you.
والله يريد أن يتوب عليكم.
Allah says clearly that Allah wants from you that He forgives you.
ويريد الذين يتبعون الشهوات.
And those who follow the whims and fancies and desires.
أن تميلوا ميلا عظيما.
They want you to turn away. They want you to turn far away.
الذكي.
The one who's intelligent.
العاقل.
The one who has a brain.
يختار.
Chooses.
ما أراده الله.
What Allah wants.
ليس ما أراده الشياطين.
And not what the shayateen and the devils want.
الله سبحانه وتعالى يريد أن يرحمنا.
Allah wants to have mercy on us.
أن يتوب علينا.
To forgive us.
أن يغفر لنا.
To forgive us.
أن يحبنا.
To love us.
أن يتجاوز عنا.
To expiate our sins.
أن يخفف عنا.
And to make easy for us.
أن يدخلنا الجنة.
And to grant us entry into Jannah.
وأهل الشهوات.
But as for those who are calling towards whims and fancies.
يريدون منا أن نميل ميلا عظيما.
They want us to turn away in a very bad way.
نحن مع من?
Who will we be with?
مع الله.
With Allah سبحانه وتعالى. Right?
الله.
ما شاء الله.
شيخ. We will be back. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
بارك الله.
Time out.
بارك الله.
بس دقيقة.
ما شاء الله. ما شاء الله.
شوف.
لا بأس.
شوف.
ما شاء الله.
ما شاء الله.
ما شاء الله. They say the time is out. Time is up.
This is example for time out. Some sheikh sit down here. يعني you must be understand. Go outside.
ما شاء الله.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
ورحمة الله وبركاته. بارك الله. ما شاء الله.
الله يحفظكم.
Keep on mic. We have one.
Okay. نعم لا لا نكمل
الحمد لله جزاكم الله خير for that session. Now we're going to have our final session, which is a panel session with all of our mashayikh, inshallah. If I can kindly ask everyone that after the panel session, we have some important announcements. So if you can stay seated until the end of the announcements, inshallah. Other than that, jazakumullah khair, you've been an amazing audience. I'll hand over to the panel now, especially our Sheikh, Sheikh Sayyid Al-Qadi.
May Allah bless you and reward you all. Jazakumullah khair. I'm sure, mashallah, you've heard beautiful verses of the Quran. And I'm sure that many of us today have decided to come closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's about making a decision, because you know that as the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, that the Jannah is closer to you than your shoes. Meaning the Jannah is very close to you. You might just subhanahu wa ta'ala sleep and pass away and then you enter Jannah. And with this subhanAllah point, I would like just to mention a joke. We'd be mashallah ta'ala terrified or scared maybe with many of the hadith and the verses. It's about a person who came from Africa. He never been to Europe at all, or to modern city or developed country. So subhanAllah, he went to Mecca. In Mecca, he couldn't afford, subhanAllah, the heat there, difficulties there. So he fainted. Okay? They took him to the hospital. He was there in the hospital. And he was surrounded by all those nurses wearing white clothes, beautiful clothes. And they were looking after him, mashallah. But he was fainted. Suddenly he woke up. As soon as he woke up, all the nurses came around him, very happy, mashallah ta'ala, enjoy. And when he saw them all coming to him, he thought that he's in paradise, in Jannah, and that they are the Hur al-Ain. He told them, one by one, don't rush, inshallah ta'ala, I can take you one by one. Make sure that, inshallah ta'ala, you don't say this, inshallah ta'ala, unless in Jannah. May Allah bless you and reward you. Okay, brothers and sisters, inshallah, we'll begin with, we'll make it more friendly, inshallah ta'ala. طيب, I would like to ask the mashayikh, inshallah ta'ala, a few questions. Beginning with Sheikh Murtada, you haven't spoken at all today. طيب, Sheikh Murtada, if you could mention a verse of the Quran that touched you so much. And whenever you recite it, you feel that you come closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you could mention, inshallah ta'ala, I will let Shaykh inshallah Mansour to recite it.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Wa usalli wa sallim ala nabiyyina Muhammad. Wa ala alihi wa sahbihi. Wa man tamassaka bi sunnati la yawmidin amma ba'd. Great privilege to be sitting here with such honorable guests and speakers, inshallah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq and ability to make us amongst those individuals الَّذِينَ يَسْتَمِعُونَ الْقَوْلَ فَيَتَّبِعُونَ أَحْسَنَهُ, to ponder and reflect over these verses and to implement them to the best of our ability. As for a verse inside the Qur'an, there's many verses inside the Qur'an that move the heart and the mind of the individual. But probably one verse that comes to mind is moment in time.
الرحيم قل إن كنتم تحبون الله فاتبعوني يحببكم الله ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم والله غفور رحيم.
So this verse that we find inside Surah Al-Imran, some verse number 30 or so, whereby we find that many ulama have called this the verse of testing oneself, or the verse of examination. It's Imam Al-Wahid in his book of Asbab al-Nuzul mentions that this is the verse to test your iman, to test your belief regarding or towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And thus this verse it mentions, say, if you believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then what is the result, what is the action you need to show to prove what your love is towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? So Allah mentions, فَاتَّبِعُونِي, follow me, follow the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and in return Allah will love you and forgive you and pardon your sins.
May Allah bless you and reward you. Khair.
Ready?
طيب ان شاء الله move to Sheikh Abu Abdussalam ان شاء الله. Sheikh Abu Abdussalam, you want a question or you want a challenge? Challenge or question? Challenge with 100 pound. Seriously, if you win you can get 100 pound. You want a question, huh? خلاص beautiful. طيب Sheikh Abu Abdussalam, give us a story that touched your heart. A story that whenever you remember, subhanAllah ta'ala, it brings you closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Almighty. A story from, it can be from the Prophet stories or from the companions.
He's ready to sing a nasheed for 100 pounds to go to charity. Maybe somebody in the audience might give 500 pounds if you sing a nasheed to a charity.
You can do that? Can you mention to us, inshallah ta'ala, an embarrassing situation that you went through? طيب يلا, go ahead.
I should have gone for the first question. At least prepare us before this. Embarrassing situation. There's so many, I don't know where to start. La ilaha illallah. There's one I was with, I mentioned this before, I don't know, some of you may have heard this. When I was, many, many, many years ago, when Sheikh Ibn al-Uthaymeen, rahimahullah, was alive, he used to do lessons in Mecca, just on the first floor of the Haram. And during that time, his lessons used to be after Salatul Maghrib. And in order to get close to the Sheikh, you had to get there for Asr time and then just sit there all the way up until Salatul Maghrib. And because it was hot days, these are my excuses coming out now. Really hot day, by the time Maghrib comes, you're quite tired. So when I was sitting down, and I used to have this Emirati brother sitting next to me. So both of us would sit. And there's literally, I could say maybe thousands of people sitting there listening to the Sheikh's lessons. And it was like the first few days of Dhul Hijjah. And during that time, on one occasion, I was sitting very close to the Sheikh. So you can imagine the chair was somewhere there, and I was sitting where I'm sitting here on the floor. And I was wearing a white shimagh, like Mufti's shimagh. It wasn't as sharp as that. He's going to get me back later. But I was wearing a white shimagh like this, and Sheikh Ibn Uthaymeen was giving a dars, and I started snoozing because it was really hot, I was tired. And so next thing I know, I find myself pretty much asleep, and this Emirati brother who spoke in English, he, you know, nudged me really hard. And I woke up like really angry, "Why are you nudging me?" So he says, "Look over there." So I look, and there's the Sheikh. He's staring at me in front of all of these people, and he's just literally staring at me. So he's asking me a question. And the way the Sheikh used to be is if he asks you a question, he expects you to stand up. I didn't know. My Arabic language was very weak at that time. So I could understand. La la aswa. I could understand, but I couldn't speak very well. So the Sheikh asked the question again. He said, "What is the?" It was a really easy question. "What is the definition of zawal?" Right? Now, everybody knows that. It's when the sun is at its highest peak. But in my mind, I was trying to translate it from English into Arabic. So my computer in my mind was going on overdrive. And I was just really trying hard to find the words to express myself into Arabic. But during this time, what I'm not noticing is that the Shaykh is sitting there telling me to stand up. Qum, stand up. And I'm not noticing this. So I'm just sitting there, you know, just waiting, trying to think about how can I translate this into Arabic so I can answer the Shaykh's question. Eventually the Shaykh was really, really angry, and he's almost off his chair like this. So this Emirati guy nudges me again, and he says, Qum. So I stood up, and the Shaykh's asking me, why didn't you stand up when I told you to stand up? So the Emirati brother, he got me out of trouble, and he says, لا يتكلم اللغة العربية. He doesn't speak Arabic. So then the Shaykh sat down, he goes, ah, ما عليك حرج. Sit down, no problem. Don't worry. Problem was, 2 days later, I was sitting in a similar position, and once again, I hadn't learned my lesson. And I was sitting in the same similar position, and I was still falling asleep in the lesson. And this time, I think I was wearing a red shimakh, so maybe the Shaykh didn't recognize me. And similar situation, Emirati guy is nudging me. And so I wake up, I see the Shaykh staring at me. But this time, I knew the drill, right? I thought, okay, he wants me to stand up. I'm not going to get in trouble. I stood up. And I see all these people around me, and then I realize, I don't know what the question is. So I'm literally standing there like a plum, like no idea what's going on. And so I'm looking around for help, like who's going to help me? And luckily there was another brother who's actually studying in Medina, now a big sheikh, mashallah. And he was sitting somewhere over there. And he asked me the question in English. But before that happened, actually, as I was standing up and I realized I didn't know what the question was, the Shaykh says to me, so he's just looking at me. So I'm thinking, how am I going to get out of this? And then I just said, I thought I was clever. So I said, لا أتكلم اللغة العربية. I don't speak Arabic. In Arabic. Okay. You don't mess with Shaykh Ibn Uthaymeen, rahmatullahi alayh. He goes, ما في مشكلة, قل في لغتك, say it in your own language. I'm like, oh man. So at that point, I was completely finished. So I'm looking around, alhamdulillah, I see a brother somewhere over there from England. And he told me what the question was. And the worst thing is that the question was even easier than the last question. It was, is it permissible to prostrate to the sun? And so he said it in English, so I just said la in Arabic. So the Shaykh sat down. After that, I never ever sat there again. I made sure I sit somewhere near Zamzam. So if I'm falling asleep in the lesson, then I get some Zamzam and splash my face.
What a beautiful story, mashallah ta'ala. Who amongst you know Shaykh Ibn Baz? If you know him, raise your hand. Sheikh Ibn Baz was one of the greatest scholars in Saudi. Was the Grand Mufti before the existing one now. And who knows Sheikh Ibn Uthaymeen? MashaAllah, raise your hand if you know him. MashaAllah, many of you. Okay, Sheikh Ibn Uthaymeen, the Sheikh was with Sheikh Abdul Salam. He was, MashaAllah, very humble, very knowledgeable, very humble. SubhanAllah, he served the fiqh in a very, subhanAllah ta'ala, beautiful manner to make it very simple and accessible to people. But Sheikh Ibn Uthaymeen, he had a lot, subhanAllah, a lot of stories that are funny. In one occasion, he was in Mecca, and he used to be very humble and go by himself, subhanAllah ta'ala, although he's very knowledgeable and well-known. So he got a taxi, and the taxi man asked him, who with me? Said to him, I'm with you, Muhammad Al-Uthaymeen. Said to him, the Sheikh? Said, yes, Sheikh. MashaAllah, he said. What's your name? He told him, my name is Abdulaziz Ibn Baz. My name is Ibn Baz. You know Ibn Baz? The Sheikh. But you know that Ibn Baz. Ibn Baz is sightless. He cannot see. He told him, but are you Ibn Uthaymeen? So he was, subhanAllah ta'ala, not believe in him because he was very humble and very, subhanAllah, down to earth. May Allah bestow his mercy upon him. طيب, back to the Mashaykh, inshaAllah. Who shall I pick now?
Who shall I pick? Vote, who shall I pick? Huh? I can't hear you. Mufti Bank. Sheikh Mufti. تفضل ان شاء الله. التليفون معك. طيب. Sheikh Mufti would like to ask a question about your journey in seeking knowledge and how can we bring our children to love the knowledge and to love the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to call people towards it.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. I think firstly we need to encourage those who might not be within homes that are very religious to say there is a lot of hope definitely and you can achieve. I hear a lot of children saying make dua, I want to be like you. And I say why like me? Be better than me. You know, aim for the Sahaba, those were the true stars. I am a nothing. And to be honest, you know, we try our best to deliver the goods. We try to learn. We try to put into practice as best as we can and to deliver to others. And we face a lot of obstacles and challenges. And we also correct ourselves where we've gone wrong. And we appreciate those who correct us in the best possible way. But when I was young, I was fortunate from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I'm the 8th of 9 siblings. And we grew up in a home that was filled with ibadah and salah and the da'wah from the very beginning. So I haven't really known a different life from that. And I noticed that those people who have been blessed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, where for generations they have had huffaz and mashayikh and ulama and so on, their challenges somehow are less from one angle, and that is they have a team of people around them that people may not know about. And they have a lot of strength that they are blessed with. So when I talk about myself sometimes, I feel people might look and say, you know what, this example can't fit with us. And that's why I started off by saying, I want to give hope to those who might be from a home that may not be absolutely religiously inclined. Because there are so many examples of people who've become great scholars and yet they struggled in their upbringing. They struggled a lot. They've been through the thick and thin, as we say, through the mill. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us ease. But I was fortunate, I learned the Quran at a very, very tender age. In fact, from the time I learned how to speak, I remember verses of the Quran that I used to memorize the age of 3 and 4. And I still recall when I was a little boy, they used to call me because the older shuyukh who used to teach in the madrasa near my home, they used to be fascinated by the fact that I could read Quran correctly. And my father, by the way, is a disciplinarian. Very, very, he's like a perfectionist almost. So they used to tell me, right, sit and read. And you know, a quiet boy, you know what happens sometimes to little children? They say, no, I don't want to read. And then you go to tell them, no, read. You say, okay, no, I don't want. They say, read, I'll give you 1 cent. That time 1 cent was like a penny. You know, a penny, our currency was stronger than yours at that time. And yes, I'm talking about Zimbabwe. Go and check it out, mashallah. The currency was stronger than yours. So subhanallah, they told me, we give you a cent. And then I would sit and read. Not that I wanted the cent. Well, I actually don't know because I was a little kid, honestly. But I just recall, they would say, don't worry, we give you something. Sit me down. And I would read. And I still know the verses I used to read. And from there, I became interested in the Quran. Memorized the Quran at a young age, started learning. My father used to teach a lot of the books of fiqh and so many other things. And I used to sit with him. I used to travel with him. I used to learn a lot. My brothers, knowledgeable. My sisters, they've learned quite a bit with my dad. To this day, my father teaches Arabic and tafsir and so many things to his grandchildren, subhanallah. And he runs several institutes. In fact, now we're involved in that particular work. So as I grew up, alhamdulillah, I was fortunate to do things. And at the same time, I was so keen on my schooling, my secular education. And I happened to be going to a government school at the beginning. When I got to high school level, alhamdulillah, I went to one of the best colleges that was back at home in Zimbabwe. And as I was finishing my secondary school, I always wanted to become an ophthalmologist. And I knew that, okay, I've learned the deen, I've learned a lot, but
In my heart, I used to think to myself, I want to become an ophthalmologist. I had something about eyes. I don't know what it was. But I always wanted to, you know, learn about it and perhaps help people in that regard. Until one day I just saw, and this is a fact, there was a letter that came for me, and we didn't used to get letters. You know, we were kids. We grew up. No one used to write to us. In the post box, at the post office, the letter came in. And it was addressed to me, and I was excited. And it was an acceptance from Medina Munawwara. And I'm thinking, but hang on, I didn't apply. How did it come?
Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar.
I didn't apply. How did it come? And so, subhanAllah, I found out later that we had some guests from Medina a few years prior to that. And they were with me, with my dad and so on. And they told my dad, you know, we want this guy to come to Medina Munawwara. They took my details from him. And they actually put it forth in a way that the acceptance came in. But I hadn't applied. I was still waiting for a response from a university where I had applied in the US, subhanAllah. And you know what happened? My father says, listen. Here there is a ticket, there is an acceptance from Medina Munawwara. You can't say no. You have to go. And I was like, oh, really? Do I have to go? Like have to? He says, yes, you have to go. And when you go, subhanAllah, what will happen is, if you don't like it, you can come back. But you have to go and try. So I said, okay, Bismillah. And I was excited. And I think he got my brothers to try and, you know, tell me and psych me up. MashaAllah, you know, MashaAllah, you're going. One of my brothers was already there before me, subhanAllah, in the faculty of Quran. And it's amazing how when I left, my mind was made up to say, I'm going to sacrifice. Because they told me about the heat. They told me about the food. They told me about the living conditions. You know, don't think I'm going to Medina. So like you're going to be in 5-star. It's like -5-star. Subhanallah. Because you're tested so much that, you know, when you're sleeping, there are all these dirty kittens all around you. By the way, the kittens there are not the kittens that you find here. You know, sometimes they're so scary because if you just look at them and they look spooky, by the way. I think the people who studied in Saudi would actually know what I'm talking about. So, amazingly, I went through and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it such, I'm cutting a long story short, that I remained. And I remember I was studying at the beginning, you know, I used to miss home and I used to feel. And then I used to hear the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, where he says, إِنَّ الْمَدِينَةَ طَيِّبَةٌ تَنْفِي الْخَبَثْ كَمَا يَنْفِي الْكِيرُ خَبَثَ الْحَدِيدِ. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, Medina is pure. It kicks away impurity from it in the same way that a blacksmith, when he blows into the ore, kicks away or blows away all the dirt. So I felt, nah, you know what? I can't leave this place. If I leave, I might just be the dirt that is being spoken about in this hadith. So I built this courage. I stayed. And a year and a half later, I fell in love with the place so much that I didn't want to come back. I carried on and completed, and today I am where I am. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us. We still have a journey with knowledge. Every day is a day of learning. And the goodness about a believer is whenever you're reminded about something, you actually take that reminder. And it's like sometimes you've never heard this before, but you know it. But you were reminded about it. So this is just a little snippet of what I was asked to say. It's not the best of topics, but Jazakumullah khair. I hope I've encouraged a few people, inshallah, to do better than me by the will of Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala.
May Allah bless you, Shaykh Mufti Ismail Mufti Menk. May Allah bless you, reward you. Brothers and sisters, you can write your questions, inshallah ta'ala, and pass them until to us here, inshallah, so we can as well read them if you want. Till then, inshallah ta'ala, we have, after my question, you have, inshallah ta'ala, challenge by Shaykh Naif. He would like to challenge you mathematically. He's saying that if you beat him, you can have a prize from him, inshallah ta'ala. And his challenge is, who can reach to number 30 first? You have three choices. You can say either one number or two number or three numbers. The one who reached to number 30 first, he is the winner. Okay, we can try it in a bit, inshallah ta'ala. Before this, my question is, there is a chapter in the Quran. A chapter in the Quran, in each verse of that chapter, the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is mentioned. If you know the chapter, raise your hand. A chapter in the Quran, in each verse of it, the name of Allah ta'ala is mentioned. Brother, can you take the microphone there, sister? Join them, may Allah bless you, reward you.
over there.
Oh, a long journey, huh?
May Allah bless every one of you.
طيب, if you have questions, please write them and pass them over. Over there. Raise your hand, sister. MashaAllah. A chapter in the Quran, in each verse of that chapter, the name of Allah Ta'ala is mentioned. There, no. Yeah. There, at the end. Raise your hand, sister. Yes. JazakAllah khair.
Surah Mujadila.
Al-Mujadila, MashaAllah. Takbir. She's right, and you deserve a gift, inshallah ta'ala. Next question will be after the challenge of Sheikh Naif. Sheikh Natadhan. Who is good in mathematics? In maths. Okay. Take that brother. That brother with the glass, mashallah. Yes. You. If you can reach number 30 first, you will deserve a gift, okay? Stand up, inshallah. Sheikh Naif, you begin or he begins? Who starts?
Up to you.
Allah, 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 Allah.
Go for it. You first.
Me? 1, 2, 3.
4, 5, 6.
7, 8.
9, 10. 11, 12.
13, 14.
15.
16, 17, 18.
19, 20.
20, 21, 22.
23.
I think I will be with 22, yes. Go ahead.
23.
23, 24, 25, 26.
27.
28, 29, 30.
Allahu Akbar.
This one?
Not anyone 20. Else?
Give him the mic.
One more. Okay, that side here, inshallah, brother. Here, inshallah, Sheikh Joinal. Jazakallah khair. Sorry. Here, inshallah. Here. No. If you stand up and come here, we're not going to choose you. Come. Sit where you are.
I've got this.
You start or Sheikh starts?
Sheikh starts.
طيب, listen. Listen, Sheikh Naif. The prize is £100 from me, but you have to win.
Inshallah.
Okay.
Inshallah.
Okay.
I will be make dua.
Inshallah.
Go ahead. 1.
2, 3.
4, 5, 6. Okay, sir. Go ahead.
7, 8, 9.
7, 8, 10 only. 10.
11, 12.
13, 14. Quickly.
15.
15, 16, 17, 18.
19, 20, 21.
22.
23, 24.
25, 26.
27.
28, 29, 30.
No! No!
Give him the mic.
Anyone more? Any more? MashaAllah. طيب, this side, inshallah ta'ala. He came, he moved from his place. I can't choose him. Brother, go, inshallah ta'ala, yes. Mike Tyson. Yalla, Sheikh Naif.
I am the same Michael Tyson, you know? Huh? Who is this one? Ah, assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi, Sheikh.
Start, our start.
Asa. 1.
2.
3, 4.
5, 6.
7, 8, 9, 10.
No, 7, 8, 9 only.
7, 8, 9.
10.
11, 12.
13, 14.
15, 16.
18. 17, 18, no problem. 19. 17, 18.
19.
19, 20, 21, 22. That's finished.
20. 23.
22.
23.
24, 25, 26.
7.
Complete.
27, 28, 29.
29, 30. Ho.
I will ask you, Sheikh Naif, another question. Just you can have a seat.
Thank
now.
You. I think nobody can winner.
طيب, I challenge Sheikh Naif with another game. If you can reach number 20 before me, can you?
Again?
من يصل
لا I want to practice.
No, let's try.
Thirty.
بعدين لا نجرب بعدين إن شاء الله. One two.
Three.
Four five.
Six.
Seven eight.
19.
طيب 11 11
12
13
14
15 16 17
18
19 20
This is for a small one. I want big one. Fifth. Because I want practice. 20 practice. Okay, thank you.
جزاك الله خير. طيب
والله شوف
You have the gifts, so.
Allah Sheikh.
JazakAllah khair.
Allah yasa'idkum izzak.
I will ask Sheikh Naif questions. One, but inshallah we can finish with 20 or more. Who can challenge with number 20? Number 20. طيب. The brother here, the young brother here, mashallah, son.
Come
on the stage. Come on the stage here. JazakAllah khair. So we can see you. If you win, inshallah, can have £100. Seriously. You want to touch it? Feed it. Does it want to come out?
Okay, it's here.
If you win, you will have £100. Have it. Hold it. Yeah. Bye. One, two.
Three, four.
Five.
Six, seven, eight.
Oh, no. Two numbers.
Six,
two numbers.
Seven.
Eight.
9
10 11
12 13
14
15
16 17
18
19
20 كسلك شوف سلام ديش
اوكي هو وانا تشالنج this side, inshallah.
This is a gift from me.
Jazakallah khair. Brother there, inshallah, with okay. With hub.
This is for gift.
MashaAllah. Allah.
Gift. Wallahi. For him. Yes.
أنا أعطيه شيخ الغفت.
No, from me.
May Allah bless you. MashaAllah. Takbir.
Go.
طيب.
This is gift
Brother
for
with
you.
This one. Inshallah.
Gift for you. From me.
Sheikh Joinal, let him touch the 100.
Even.
Not you. Him, not. Okay, quickly, but okay. One, two.
Three, four.
Five.
Six.
Seven, eight.
Nine.
10, 11.
12.
13, 14.
15, 16.
17.
18.
19, 20. You are good, mashallah alaik. طيب, now I have a question, inshallah, for Sheikh Naif. I'll finish with you. Sheikh Naif and Sheikh Mufti Mink, if you could, inshallah ta'ala, with your beautiful and highly skilled translation. May Allah bless you and reward you, wallahi. If you could, inshallah ta'ala, translate for Sheikh Naif, don't mind, inshallah. The question for Sheikh Naif is, what is the most funny situation that you went through? The funniest.
I have a lot of situation.
Allah.
Because I think me same center. What is that? Justin Bieber.
Allah, I don't know him.
أنا أذكر يا شيخ.
Okay.
عندنا نحن نأتي للشباب في أماكن تجمعاتهم.
He says, I remember we come to the youth, you know, in the places where they gather. And we know there's a lot of goodness in our youth, male and female. Even if sometimes, you know, they might run away from the masjid and do a thing or two that's bad sometimes. But we know in the heart there's a lot of goodness. So he says, one day we went onto the seaside.
قبل صلاة الفجر.
Before صلاة الفجر.
لأن عندنا التوقيت في السعودية غير التوقيت هنا.
Because the timing in Saudi is very different from here.
أيوة. فكان البحر ممتلئ بالشباب.
So at that time the seaside was filled with a lot of youth.
فجهزنا مكان مثل هذا للصلاة.
So we prepared a place just like this for salah.
وقبل الصلاة أخذت المايك.
And before salah I took a microphone.
وبدأت أضحك مع الشباب وأمزح معهم وداعبهم.
I started cracking a few jokes with the people, with the youngsters.
فبدأ الشباب يحضرون بالمئات.
So hundreds of the youngsters started coming together and find, you know, trying to listen.
فجاءني شاب ووقف جنبي.
So a young boy came up to me and stood in front of me.
فقال لي أنا ارتحت لك وأحببتك.
He says, "Oh, you know, I really feel calm with you, and I really like you."
ولابس كاب كذا، لابس كاب على الجنب.
And he was wearing his cap on the one side.
Short.
And he was wearing shorts.
وكان رائحة الخمر تخرج منهم.
And he was smelling quite strongly of alcohol.
سكران يعني.
He was drunk.
فقال أريد أن أصلي معكم.
He says, "I want to pray with you guys."
فما أحببت أن أقول له أنت سكران، قلت أنت لابس شورت ولا تستطيع أن تصلي إلا بستر العورة.
So he said, instead of me saying that, you know what, you're drunk and you shouldn't be here, I just told him, you know what, if you want to pray, you're actually wearing shorts, you need to wear something longer than what you are wearing right now.
فقال لي سلام عليكم.
So he said سلام عليكم.
راح.
And he went away.
I said الحمد لله.
So I said الحمد لله.
After 5 minutes.
After 5 minutes.
No, بعد خمس دقائق. Say.
بعد خمس دقائق. طيب.
هو ذهب ولبس جلابية وحضر إلي.
He went. He wore something. He wore a thobe, you know, long one like this, and he came back.
قال لي كيف؟
He says now everything's okay.
قلت له كيف بس أنت سكران.
He says then I had to tell him, hey, you know what? It's okay, but you're drunk. You know, you don't know what's happening.
قال لي لا 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 أنا شربت بعد المغرب.
He says no I'm not drunk. I drank after صلاة المغرب yesterday.
الآن أنا كويس.
He says now I'm fine.
قلت له توضى وصل معنا.
So I said, okay, make wudu and come and pray with us.
صلى معنا قرابة الألف شاب.
That day, about 1,000 youngsters read salah with us.
فكان بعد الصلاة قام أحد المشايخ وتكلم عن أضرار التدخين والمخدرات.
So after salah, one of the sheikhs got up and started speaking about the harms of smoking and drugs.
وقال لهم في مستشفى عندنا لعلاج الإدمان.
And he says there is a hospital here near us that would actually treat the addictions.
وأنا جالس أمام هذا الشيخ.
And he says I was sitting right in front of the sheikh.
وكان المكان مفتوح open area.
And it was an open area, مكان مفتوح.
وكان هذا الشاب واقف أمامنا هنا على يمين الشيخ.
And this young boy who was smelling of alcohol was standing on the right side of the sheikh.
الشيخ قال تعلمون يا شباب أن في المستشفى عندنا بلغ عدد الشباب والفتيات خلال 20 سنة الذين يتعالجون من المخدرات 50,000.
He says the sheikh was saying that do you know my young children that the number of people at this hospital that deals with addictions has over the years has actually come to 50,000.
هذا الشاب سمع هذا الكلام.
So the young boy heard this.
فجاء يمشي إلي هكذا.
He came walking to the sheikh in this particular way.
رمى نفسه عليه.
And he threw himself on the sheikh.
قال 51,000.
He said 51,000.
يحتاج إلى
مستشفى. Catch the joke? Did you catch what he said? He counts himself worth 1,000 people. That was what, because he was tipsy.
يحتاج إلى مستشفى لوحده.
So he says, the sheikh is now saying that this guy needed a whole hospital for himself.
هذا يعني هذا موقف من المواقف.
So he says, I laughed so much because I really knew this guy was drunk.
والمواقف كثيرة.
And he says there's so many, you know, different types of occasions when they were when I laughed.
نحن في الخليج.
He says in the Gulf.
إذا قابلت رجل في مكان ما.
If you meet a person in a place.
في مدينة أو في دولة.
In a city or a country.
مثلا قابلتك في جدة.
If I see you in Jeddah, for example.
أقول لك شيخ مفتي نورت جدة.
I use the term نورت جدة. That means Jeddah is shining because of your presence.
فأنا في يوم من الأيام كنت في مدينة من المدن.
So he says one day I went to one of the cities.
فدخلت إلى دورات المياه.
And I went into the bathroom, the loo.
فقابلت شاب عمره 15 سنة.
So I saw a young boy 15 years old.
فحينما رآني فرح.
So when he saw me, he was so excited.
فقال لي نور الحمام.
So he said, oh, the toilet is shining.
قلت له نعم.
So I told him, what did you just say?
قال أخطأ من شدة الفرح.
He says, no, I made a mistake. I was too excited, you know.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
السلام ورحمة الله. بارك الله.
Now we have a beautiful, inshallah ta'ala, section, which is with the Shaykh. May Allah bless him and reward him, Shaykh Mansour. He will give us a beautiful nasheed. Allahu Akbar. Takbir! A nasheed that connects us with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Almighty.
Shaykh Mufti, أنت لازم أن تكون معي.
واحد واحد إن شاء الله.
طيب. سأقبل يا خالقي من جديد.
I will come forth to you, O my Creator, all anew.
كما أنت مني إلهي تريد.
Exactly as you want from me, O my Lord.
وأرجو إذا أنت تقبلني.
And I hope from you that you accept from me.
جنان الخلود ومنك المزيد.
You grant me the paradise of eternity and from you that which is extra over and above that.
جنان الخلود ومنك المزيد. عصيتك ربي فأمهلتني.
I've committed so many sins against you, O my Lord, and you have given me so much time.
وتسترني رغم أني عنيت.
And you've hidden all my sins from the people, even though I continued.
لأنك ربي غفور ودود.
Because you, O my Lord, are the most forgiving, most loving.
رحيم بكل الورى والعبيد.
You are most merciful upon all humankind and all your worshippers.
رحيم بكل الورى والعبيد. سأترك يا رب ذنبا مضى.
I promise you, my Lord, that I will quit all my previous sins.
وأقبل نحو الرضا والنعيم.
And I will go forth towards your happiness and towards the gifts that you have prepared.
لماذا؟
Why?
أحبك ربي وهذا رجائي.
Because I love you so much, my Lord, and this is my hope.
بأنك تقبلني يا كريم.
That you accept me as I am, O my Lord.
بأنك تقبلني يا كريم.
That you accept me, O my Lord, filled with great honor.
شكرا شيخ مفتي.
بارك الله فيكم ما شاء الله.
تكبير. تكبير لاودر. I can't hear you. لاودر. تكبير. جزاكم الله خير. طيب, all those who entered the challenge and did not win, can you come quickly here, inshallah, to have a quick or small gift? Those who were with us in the challenge, the game challenge, come quickly, inshallah. Come here on the stage. جزاكم الله خير. طيب, now we're going to have your questions, inshallah ta'ala, asked by Brother Umar to the Shuyukh. And then we're going to have the final, inshallah, bit of the session after the questions, inshallah. Sheikh Mansour, تستريح, inshallah.
Alaykum wa rahmatullah. Very quickly, just before I ask the questions, a number of questions came in, and some of them, if they don't get asked, don't take it personally. Due to the complexity of some of the questions, it's not appropriate for a quick format where we can put it on the mashayikh to just give you an answer. They require a lot more thought. So they haven't been asked for that reason. But some of the questions, definitely I would say for the people asking them, go to people of knowledge. There are other people of knowledge. Book some time with them in your local imams, or there's other... And she was advised by a sheikh that she perhaps shouldn't be with her husband, but she's also been told to make dua for her husband. Sheikh Saeed, so the wife's practicing, the husband isn't. What should she do? So the husband doesn't pray.
Beautiful, beautiful question for Sheikh Murtada Khan.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Firstly, we shouldn't bring such questions in the common arena. These are questions that should be dealt specifically with specific ulama. Questions such nature shouldn't become very loose in our tongue or something that we should rejoice or be happy about. Personal issues and personal affairs should be dealt with specialists. And in general, for anyone to give a ruling that the husband's not practicing and so the wife to be advised that to leave the husband or the husband to be advised to leave his wife, this is not appropriate in a common arena for people to just give blank answers or quick answers to people that the husband's not practicing, so you can just separate from the husband. It should be raised to a Sharia counsel specialist to look into great detail about the situation and then come to a conclusion. And I personally advise all young brothers and sisters to stay away from entering into such discussions about other people's family affairs or advising another sister to leave her husband, or for brothers to advise their a brother to leave their wife, etc. This all leads down to a downfall inside our society and many problems that we're facing at the moment. The people who don't have the skills and experience and ability to give religious verdicts to other people to separate from their husband or separate from their wife. And it's not befitting for us to discuss such affairs, inshallah. Barakallahu fi.
Jazakumullah khair. The next question. When a person has reached 60 years old, and I guess it's the same for any senior age, how can they maximize their ibadah? And they reach the late years, how can they maximize their ibadah? So when they reach 60 years old, for example, they feel they don't have the energy or the strength, what's the best things they can do?
Very good question for Sheikh Abu Salam.
Not because of his 60? Age.
Ask Mufti Menki, he's nearly 60, huh?
No, mashallah. In terms
how can
of
you
good
maximize
deeds.
Ibadah? SubhanAllah, I think...
I'll take it.
You want to take it? I'm worried now.
You take mine.
I'm worried now.
You take mine.
Subhanallah, you take it.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. The reason I'm taking the question, firstly, is my age. I'm quite older than Sheikh Abu Abdus Salam, alhamdulillah. And secondly is, my question is going to be a really tough one. He can have it, inshallah. Okay. You didn't get the catch until, mashallah, you handed it over well. Okay. The ibadah, as you grow older, you become closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Your bones begin to ache sometimes. Your health begins to show signs that it's no longer as it was. This starts happening, in fact, at 40, 41, 42, 45, 50, and you start noticing changes. This is the gift of Allah. It's the mercy of Allah that you're aging. Why? Because you have such a blessed gift. Allah is telling you, hey, you're coming back to us, start preparing now, subhanallah. A person who dies suddenly at a young age, what preparation did they have? They are upon the mercy of Allah. Not to say the older ones are not, but the older ones, you know what? It becomes more likely that you calm down. This is why you're asking, what ibadah should I engage in? Can I tell you? Allah says in a hadith, there is nothing that I love more than that which I have made compulsory upon you. So, your farad salah, get up, take your time. Your subhana rabbi al-a'la. When you say it in sujood, take your time. Repeat it several times, preferably an odd number. Take your time. Don't make haste in your prayer. Take your time. Take a look at one of the muaddins at a masjid in Jeddah who passed away just a few weeks back. And I'm sure a lot of us saw the clips doing their rounds on WhatsApp and social media. This was also a man in his 60s. And what was he doing? He was in the masjid before the Adhan of Fajr, waiting for Adhan of Fajr. He opened the Quran, he's reading it, and he dropped dead. When the people came in, they saw the page he was opened the Quran on. Have you guys seen it? Subhanallah, I saw the page, it was in the 7th juz of the Quran. وَمَنْ أَظْلَمُ مِمَّنْ افْتَرَى عَلَى اللَّهِ كَذِبًا أَوْ قَالَ أُوحِيَ إِلَيَّ وَلَمْ يُوحَ إِلَيْهِ شَيْءٍ. What beautiful verses that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made mention of. That page was open and the man was gone. The people walked into the masjid and they saw he was gone. How old was he? In his 60s. What was he doing? He was there early in order to call the adhan, in order to prepare for Salatul Fajr. When you do that which Allah has made farad upon you, He loves it the most. Then you increase slowly but surely. You increase slowly but surely your sunnah and your nafil until you become so close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that everything you do is guided directly by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And one very important factor is you must always have hope in the mercy of Allah. If you're terminally ill or you're aged, or for example, you're a person who, you're growing in age, anything may be going wrong, and even if nothing's going wrong in your life, have hope in the mercy of Allah. Sometimes people fear death so much that they become depressed. No, you need to be convinced that you're going to a better place. You have to be convinced within yourself that you are going into the mercy of Allah. Yes, whatever sins we've done, Allah will forgive them. And He has forgiven them. He will never deny you that forgiveness if you were genuine in seeking it. So remember this. It's something extremely important because many people lose hope. And the hadith says, "Ana inda dhanni 'abdi bi, I am as my worshipper perceives me to be with him." So you perceive Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be merciful and kind, and He will give you Jannah and so on. Listen to the beautiful reminder we had today. MashaAllah, we would actually get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by fulfilling our duties, by seeking a lot of forgiveness. That's also a very interesting point, very important. Learn to ask Allah's forgiveness, astaghfirullah. Not just pay. You see, some people, they take a counter, one of the tasbihat with beads or what have you. Nowadays, they're digital, and they say, astaghfirullah, 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 astaghfirullah. Have you heard that? And they don't even know what they've said. As you grow a little bit older, you need to start thinking, what is it that I am saying? I'm saying, oh Allah, forgive me. Oh Allah, forgive me. And that is registered next to your name. If you were to die one day and you're in the habit of seeking the forgiveness of Allah every day, the angels would have written that on this day of death of the person, he started off his day by reading a page of the Quran, by seeking the forgiveness of Allah, by reading Salatul Fajr. Where do you think you're going to go? Do you think Allah's going to say, right, we're throwing him into hell? By His mercy, He's looking for that to forgive you and grant you Jannah. So these are some of the deeds that you could actually do. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy. The last point I quickly want to say, it's not only those who are old, but in fact everyone who should be doing this. Wallahu a'lam.
Jazakumullah khair, Mufti Meng. Last question. I'm going to reword it slightly so everyone can benefit from it, and I think it's very, very pertinent for our times. Is what are the consequences of being in debt, owing another person or an institution money? And the extra part of the question that the person wrote was, and having no intention of paying it back. So the two parts is, one, first of all, the gravity of being in debt, and secondly, you don't have any intention to pay it back.
The question is about debt and being in debt and not paying, not intending to pay it back. This is a huge sin in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If a person owes someone else money, in whether it's money or any other huquq, any other rights, and he doesn't give those rights, then he is highly liable in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And in fact, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he once refused to pray the janazah of somebody who was a sahabi. So you can imagine his level, he's already a sahabi. He's a companion. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam refused to pray his janazah because he died in a state of debt. And then he said, "Sallu ala sahibikum," pray over your companion. So he didn't tell them not to pray over him, salatul janazah, when he died. But he himself refused to pray over this, showing the importance of not being making sure that you pay back your debts. To be honest, the most serious part of this question, sometimes you have to go into debt. It could be for personal reasons, you don't have enough money, or it could be for business reasons, or for whatever reason, sometimes you have to go into debt. But the real crux of this question is the final part, and you have no intention of paying it back. Allah starts a surah of the Quran, the fifth surah of the Quran, Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu awfu bil uqud, O you who believe, fulfill your contracts, fulfill your covenants, fulfill your agreements. This is a massive problem, unfortunately, where people, we don't give each other the rights that we owe them, that we agree to. In fact, sometimes some ulama have said that if you sin against Allah, like if somebody, for example, he does a sin related to Allah, for example, he drinks alcohol, or you know, he commits a major sin that is a sin against Allah, sometimes this is not as bad as sinning when it comes to dealing with other Muslims. Why? Because if you sin against Allah, then you can make tawbah, you can ask forgiveness, and Allah will forgive you. But if you sin against another person, you take his right, then not only do you have to make tawbah, but that person has to forgive you. And if he doesn't forgive you, you can't enter paradise until the deeds have been swapped. So Allah doesn't forgive that person until either that person forgives him or deeds have been swapped. So we have to be very careful with other people's rights.
May Allah bless you and reward you, inshallah. Before the last session, inshallah ta'ala, I would like to ask Sheikh Ismail Mufti Menk and Sheikh Mansour to come forward, inshallah ta'ala, and to ask you an important question. شيخ اسماعيل
السلام عليكم.
السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته. نريد أن نكون في هذه القاعة نضع لنا شعارات.
He says here in this hall as a closing we would like to place a few points.
هذه الشعارات تكون لنا يعني نبراسا لنا في حياتنا نعمل بها.
These few points will be practical that we should be able to implement in our lives. What's the point of coming an entire day listening to beautiful verses of the Quran being recited when there are no practical points for us to take back?
الشعار الأول.
The first one.
نريد أن نمشي ونقوله ونعمل به.
We want to actually walk upon what we've learned and we want to be able to say it and work upon it.
الشعار الأول هو شعار السماء والأرض.
The first one is that from the heavens and the earth.
أتينا طائعين.
We have come in willing obedience.
الله سبحانه وتعالى يقول.
Allah says.
ثم استوى إلى السماء وهي دخان.
Then he rose above the skies and it was smoke.
فقال لها وللأرض.
And he told the skies and the earth.
ائتيا طوعا أو كرها.
Come willingly or unwillingly, meaning by force.
قالتا أتينا طائعين.
They said that we have come in willing obedience.
الشعار الأول أتينا طائعين.
So the same way the skies and the earth said that, we will also say we have come in willing obedience.
السؤال.
The question.
هل نطبق هذا الشعار؟
Will we come in willing obedience?
أكيد.
Sure.
Thanks.
It's a weak yes. Come on. We sure? Okay.
الشعار الثاني.
The second one. The second point.
هدنا إليك ومعنى هدنا إليك تبنا إليك.
We have repented to you. The term هدنا means we have repented to you, O Allah. That's the second point that we all need to take back.
نطبق.
Will we?
هذا الشعار الثاني.
Okay.
الشعار الثالث.
The third one.
إنا إلى الله راغبون.
We are indeed going towards Allah. We are attached to Allah and going towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
يكون شعارنا good.
Is that good?
Yes.
الشعار الرابع.
The fourth one.
سمعنا وأطعنا.
We have heard and we have obeyed.
وهذا شعار ماذا؟
And this is what?
شعار صحابة رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم.
It is the banner of the companions of Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم.
فنريد جميعا أن نكون مثل شعار الصحابة. سمعنا وأطعنا.
So we want all, or we should all, be similar to that of the Sahaba رضي الله عنهم. The banner that they held was, we heard and we obeyed.
غفرانك ربنا وإليك المصير.
We seek your forgiveness, O our Lord, and indeed we are going to return to you.
هذه أربعة شعارات نريد أن نعمل بها.
These are four banners or four points that we need to work upon.
بإذن الله.
By the will of Allah, is that good? Will we work upon them? الحمد لله.
هناك قواعد يجب علينا أن نحفظها ونعمل بها.
There are certain rules that we need to work upon and we need to understand them.
الأولى.
The first one.
أذكر الله يذكرك.
Remember Allah, He will remember you.
Good. ارضى عن الله يرضى عنك.
Be happy with Allah, Allah will be happy with you.
تحب الله, الله يحبك.
You love Allah, Allah will love you. Subhanallah.
تنسى الله, تعرض عن الله, الله يعرض عنك.
If you turn away from Allah, if you forget Allah, Allah will turn away from you.
كم قاعدة؟
How many rules?
Four. احفظوها واعملوا بها.
Memorize them and work on them.
السؤال الذي أريد أن أسأل به نفسي وإخواني.
The question I have for myself and yourselves.
هل إذا رآك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم أحبك؟
If Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم saw you, would he love you? Would he take to you? Question.
كيف يحبك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم؟
How would he love you?
إذا كنت على طريقته.
If you were trying to tread the straight path.
وعلى سنته.
And on his sunnah, on his way.
اللهم اجعلنا.
May Allah make us from among those
ممن يستن بسنة محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم
who follow the sunnah of Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم.
آمين.
آمين. آمين.
شيخ.
الله يحفظك.
أنا أيام الجاهلية.
He says during my own period of ignorance.
أيام الشباب الشباب.
When I was a young lad.
كنت أشجع الأرسنال.
عفوا.
كنت أشجع فريق الأرسنال في لندن.
He says I was a supporter of Arsenal.
أنا اليوم جيت لندن.
He says now I came to London today.
أرسنال فاز.
And Arsenal won.
الله.
كيف لو رحت ملعب الإمارات؟
He says what if I had gone to the Emirates Stadium?
إيش بيصير؟
What would have happened?
أتوقع أرسنال يأخذ الشامبيونز ليج.
عفوا.
يأخذ دوري الأبطال.
He says that the Arsenal would have won the
Champions League,
the big cup. Yeah, I don't know much about it anyway. حياك الله.
نحن نمزح معهم وهذا بس من باب الدعابة فقط لا غير. وأما الكرة هذه لا تقدم ولا تؤخر.
He says, you know, we're actually just sharing a light moment.
ولكن
as for the ball, you know, it doesn't come forward nor does it go back. It's just a ball. It remains a ball.
ولا يمنع أن الواحد يلعب ويمارسها. فأنا محترف كرة قدم.
He says it's not. He says it's not. You know, it's not wrong for someone to know how to play football. He says I'm actually a professional player.
كنا في رحلة.
He says.
كنا في رحلة.
He says we had gone on a journey.
قبل أن نأتي إلى لندن.
Before we came to London.
بفضل الله.
By the virtue of Allah.
هزمته بالكرة القدم.
He says I beat him in football.
كلامه صحيح.
He says yes, he is right.
جعلته يفوز علي من باب إدخال السرور على قلبه.
He says I allowed him to win because I knew that, you know, to make a believer happy is an act of worship.
ثلاث مرات إدخال السرور.
He says have you made me happy three times?
أنا الإنسان دائما الإنسان يحاول يكثر من فعل الخيرات.
He says no, a person should do lots of good deeds, not just one.
جعلته يفوز علي ثلاث مرات.
He says thrice was okay, fine.
الحمد لله. عندنا رجل في المملكة.
He says we have a person in the kingdom.
كان حارس مرمى.
He was a goalkeeper.
يحرس الهدف.
Yes, he was a goalkeeper.
الآن هو يحرس الدين.
He says now he is a keeper of the deen.
الله أكبر.
Changed his life.
في المملكة هذا نفس الرجل
هو
يقول
he says,
أنا كنت أشوت الكرة
أركل
أركل الكرة
he says I used to kick the ball
الآن أنا أركل الكرة الأرضية
he says now I kick the earth
يعني الدنيا
meaning the worldly items
أريد ما عند الله من الآخرة
he says I want what is with Allah سبحانه وتعالى
أنا عندي أهداف جميلة مصورة بالفيديو في اليوتيوب
he says on YouTube I have some beautiful goals
ما عندي مشكلة ألعب في فريق إنجليزي ليس شرط تشيلسي أو أرسنال small one
he says I don't mind playing for one of the English league teams it doesn't have to be Chelsea it could be any other small team
نسأل الله أن يسعدهم في الدنيا والآخرة
طيب. May Allah keep us all happy in the dunya and the akhirah
أنا أريد منهم طلب
I request you something he says
كلنا سمعنا هذا الكلام كلام الدين والإيمان
We all heard the speech of the deen and belief. Have we heard it?
من أراد أن يقرر التغيير من الآن يرفع يده.
Whoever would like to confirm that they are going to change positively for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, raise your hand.
يا رب.
اللهم فاشهد.
تكبير.
بارك الله.
تكبير.
ما شاء الله.
ما شاء الله أسأل الله جل في علا أن يجمعنا مع النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في الفردوس الأعلى من الجنة
May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gather us with Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم all of us in جنة الفردوس آمين
آمين وصلى الله وسلم على سيدنا ونبينا محمد وجزاكم الله عني كل خير
بارك الله فيكم
Brothers, I will make some dua إن شاء الله for those who were behind the scene working hard to make this event happen. The brothers in Knowledge First, Light Upon Light, brothers in Iman Channel, they've been working hard yesterday and today to make this event happen. May Allah bless them. Say Ameen. May Allah reward them. May Allah enable them to see the fruit of this in their children and their life. Say Ameen. The last bit of this, inshallah ta'ala, event, would like to thank all the shuyukh. May I ask Shaykh Abdullah Al-Faiz to come forward inshallah. The Mashaykh inshallah beginning with Shaykh Mufti Ismail Bank.
Salaam.
Amen. Don't be jealous Shaykh, you gotta come now.
I don't understand.
With the gift, Sheikh. Sheikh, you want the gift, Sheikh?
JazakAllah khair.
BarakAllah. And we have as well, Sheikh Mansour. He says, "Hey, Mansour." He says, "Mission my name first." Okay, Sheikh Mansour Al-Salami, mashallah.
Oh. السالمي
منصور السالمي يا الله بلس يا ريورد انا
تكبير الله اكبر
شيخ منصور لك وي هاف از ويل فضيله الشيخ نايف الصحفي
الصحفي او الصحفي
شيخ أبو عبد السلام
يا شيخ سعيد دكتور سعيد يا دكتور سعيد هذه أول زيارة لنا هنا
الله أكبر It's our first trip to the UK
إن شاء الله I will be back in December إن شاء الله
هي What should I say? الشيخ مرتضى خان ذهب May Allah bless you and reward you طيب Now inshallah ta'ala May Allah bless you all and reward you all Final words from each sheikh inshallah ta'ala In 1 minute. طيب beginning with Sheikh Abdullah Al-Faiz.
شكرا
شكرا لكم أولا على هذا الحضور الكبير، وشكرا للمشايخ شيخ مفتي، شيخ منصور، شيخ نايف، الشيخ أبو عبد السلام، الشيخ سعيد، وكل الأخوة الذين أمتعونا في هذا اليوم المبارك.
الشيخ is thanking all the مشايخ who participated in this event.
شعرت براحة نفسية تجتاح نفسي وأنا أستمع إلى هذه المحاضرات القيمة، وسألت نفسي سؤالا.
I felt the tranquility and the peace when I was listening to these lectures, and I asked myself a question.
هذه الراحة النفسية الكبيرة وهذه السكينة التي اجتاحت نفسي، ما سببها؟ ما سرها؟
What is the cause behind this tranquility that came to my heart?
ثم تذكرت قول الله جل وعلا:
ألا بذكر الله، ألا بذكر الله تطمئن القلوب.
Then I remember the verse in which Allah Ta'ala said, indeed through Allah's remembrance hearts find tranquility, peace and happiness.
ثم تذكرت السر أن الله جل وعلا خلق آدم عليه السلام من التراب ثم نفخ فيه من روحه فتحرك آدم، فكان لآدم أمران: أمر مأكل ومشرب ونوم، وهذه حاجة الجسد، وذكر الله جل وعلا، وهذه حاجة الروح.
And then I remembered how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made Adam alayhi salam from two entities, that is his body that was made from clay and also his soul that is from Allah the Almighty subhanahu wa ta'ala, and both of them they have their own food and nourishment.
أسأل الله جل وعلا أن يقيل لنا ولكم العثرات، وأن يرفع لنا ولكم الدرجات، وأن يثبتنا ويجمعنا بكم في الجنات عند الله جل وعلا.
May Allah gather us all in the Jannah under Allah's shade. We won't be any shade by His shade. Jazakallah khair, Shaykh. May Allah bless and reward you. And have a seat. Shaykh Mufti, 1 minute, final talk.
Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. I'm sure we've heard a lot of what has been said today. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept from you the fact that you have sat here for so many hours. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant every one of you acceptance. I can imagine how tired you must be, but I'm sure when we listen to the verses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it's a matter of goodness and calmness that we achieve, and nothing to do with that. But still, I think, my brothers and sisters, if we go home having moved 1 millimeter from where we were before we came, we have achieved. If we go home having moved 1 millimeter, you know, inshallah, the pace of movement towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in everyone's life should be within themselves the best that they could have done. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make myself and yourselves from among those who take the messages seriously and who try our best. May He forgive us all. Jazakumullah khair.
We'll continue. Just Sheikh will close with the live feed.
Very much so. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah to all our viewers at home.
Noorun ala noor.
In Somalia, Amina is losing her strength. She's walked miles with her baby in hope of finding aid. Now, she realizes there is none. Now is the time to say stop.